Uganda is a signatory to the International Convention of Civil Aviation of 1994, and under Article 37 of the Convention, Uganda is required to comply with the Convention's international standards and practices. The International Civil Aviation Organization conducted an audit into the aviation industry of Uganda in September 2023 and identified a number of gaps in security and safety concerns.
The ICAO auditors have so far audited critical elements 1 and 2, relating to the primary aviation legislation and regulations made under the primary aviation legislation respectively. The auditors identified gaps in the primary aviation legislation, the Civil Aviation Act, which, if not addressed immediately, affects several audit areas and may expose Uganda to adverse audit findings that could have far-reaching implications for the country.
The Minister of Works and Transport, Katumba Wamala, has informed the Committee of Fiscal Infrastructure that failure by Uganda to address security gaps identified by the September audit, the International Convention of Civil Aviation will declare Uganda unsafe for travel by air transport means.
A finding of significant safety concern is in effect a notice to the world that it's not safe to travel to Uganda by air or any registered Ugandan aircraft to operate in their skies.
The minister also added that Uganda's aviation industry is undergoing security audit, which started yesterday up to 8th February 2024, and at the time the bill was tabled before the committee, the auditors were meeting President Museveni to get assurance about Uganda's commitment towards addressing some of the issues raised.
At the heels of this now, we have the security and safety audit team, which arrived in the country on the 29th. Now, this is another audit of safety and security, and it's as critical, if not more actually, than the first one.
In the Civil Aviation Amendment Bill 2023, government proposes to insert tougher penalties for offences committed under the aviation industry.
In the amendments, we are proposing imprisonment, life imprisonment. Yet, in the Anti-Terrorism Act, for the same offence, we have death. How are we harmonizing that?
You are all aware, and you have been asking me, why aren't we flying into London? And the London team, the CAA in London, has insisted on seeing first the ICAO audit, which was done, and this audit, depending on what scores, that will determine on whether we can fly into London and some of the EU countries.
However, members of parliament raised concern over the actions of the ministry.
Is it just now that we are realizing these gaps? Haven't we had audits before?
And say, do this for us, it will go well. But you end up in problems. That's why I would be saying, are we airtight that what we are doing, that's what is required?
Some of these issues, I know they are not coming for the first time, and we have been having amendments. I'm only wondering why someone has been sleeping on a job.
The audit is not actually, in most cases, like the one we had. It's not like we are, unless you have really violated a lot of the provisions, they rarely slap bans. But they make observations and they tell you, you have a gap here, you have a gap here, you have a gap here.
Government seeks to allow an inspector to have unrestricted and unlimited access to any part of an aircraft and any records and information that may be required during the conduct of an inspection.
Inspector, right now, they do not have powers, for example, they have to contact the DG to be allowed to inspect an aircraft or to stop an aircraft from taking off.
A provision in the Act allowing civil aviation inspector to have unlimited access and unlimited access to aircraft, aviation, and what have you.
The Civil Aviation Amendment Bill 2024, which is before Parliament, proposes life imprisonment for anyone found liable upon conviction of hijacking or indulging in several acts of violence that could endanger lives of passengers on an aircraft. As government rushes to have amendments done before 7th February, the committee is expected to report back to Parliament tomorrow with a report. Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.